Here we're given the two fractions 3/8 and 5/12, and then we're asked which is larger. We'll work through this in steps. We'll begin by listing the first six multiples of 8. So if we start counting by 8s, we'd have 8, 8 plus 8 is 16, plus 8 is 24, plus 8 is 32, plus 8 is 40, plus 8 is 48. Also notice 8 times 1 is 8, 8 times 2 is 16, 8 times 3 is 24, and so on. Next, we list the first six multiples of 12. So counting by 12s, we'd have 12 plus 12 is 24, plus 12 is 36, plus 12 is 48, plus 12 is 60, plus 12 is 72. Also recognize 12 times 1 is 12, 12 times 2 is 24, and so on. Using the list of multiples, we're asked to give some of the common denominators of 8 and 12. The common denominators would be the common multiples of 8 and 12. So looking at the multiples of 8 and multiples of 12, let's see what the two lists have in common. Notice both lists contain 24 as well as 48. These are two common multiples of 8 and 12, which would also be considered common denominators of 8 and 12. So let's go ahead and list them. We have 24, 48. If we kept counting by 24s, we could determine more common denominators of 8 and 12. 48 plus 24 is equal to 72, and of course the list continues. Next, we're asked to determine the least common denominator of 8 and 12, which would be the least common multiple of 8 and 12. Looking at the common multiples or common denominators, notice how 24 is the smallest common multiple or common denominator, and therefore 24 is the least common denominator or LCD. Continuing, we're asked to create equivalent fractions for 3/8 and 5/12 using the least common denominator that we found and then determine which fraction is larger. So we want to write 3/8 as a fraction with a denominator of 24. We also want to write 5/12 as a fraction with a denominator of 24. We can create equivalent fractions by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the same value. Notice 8 times 3 is equal to 24. So if we multiply the numerator by 3, we can create an equivalent fraction. And because 3 times 3 is equal to 9, 3/8 is equivalent to 9/24. Now for 5/12, notice that 12 times 2 is equal to 24. So to create an equivalent fraction, we multiply the numerator by 2 as well. 5 times 2 is 10. We now know that 5/12 is equivalent to 10/24. So to determine which fraction is larger, 3/8 or 5/12, we can compare the equivalent fractions with the denominator of 24. So we can compare 9/24 and 10/24 to compare 3/8 and 5/12. Well, 9/24 is less than 10/24, or we can say 10/24 is greater than 9/24, and therefore 3/8 is less than 5/12, or we can say 5/12 is greater than 3/8. So as a sentence, we'll say that 5/12 is larger than 3/8. It is important that we answer the question that we do use the fractions in the original form. Now before we go, we're asked to go back to the Josh and Chase's pizza problem and answer the question, who ate more? Hopefully you remember, in a previous activity, we were told that Josh ate 3/5 of a pizza and Chase ate 2/3 of a pizza. And we were asked, who ate more pizza? Another method to compare these two fractions would be to write both the fractions as equivalent fractions using the least common denominator. Listing multiples of 5 would give us 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on. Listing multiples of 3 would give us 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, and so on. Notice how the least common multiple is 15. So if we write both fractions as equivalent fractions with denominators of 15, we can more easily compare 3/5 and 2/3. Notice for 3/5, 5 times 3 is equal to 15, and 3 times 3 is equal to 9. So 3/5 is equivalent to 9/15. And 3 times 5 is equal to 15, 2 times 5 is 10, so 2/3 is equal to 10/15. And we showed this earlier by dividing this model horizontally into 3 equal parts, and this model vertically into 5 equal parts. This shows us that 3/5 is equal to 9/15, and this shows us 2/3 equals 10/15. And because 10/15 is greater than 9/15, we know that Chase ate more pizza. Going back to our previous slide, using the least common denominator of 3/5 and 2/3, we know that Chase ate more pizza. I hope you found this helpful.